Yes, what's up?
Yeah, what's up?
Yes.
Where are we going now? Yeah, where are we going?
What's up? Police station.
Yeah, what's happening?
The machine.
Hematic?
Yes.
For?
For, tax
retail. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
There's a person. There's a person. So we have a... So listen, we have a minibus over there escorting us. We have the police right here. You can see the minibus is there. Then you can see the crowd. That is right there. The ladies are marching because of the crime, the violence that is really taking place. So we're going to pick up one student. You know, supporting this, can you just tell the people there?
No, I'm going to the police station. I want to say, we've had enough of their acts. We are being killed, we are being shot, we are being stepped to death. Our police officials are not doing anything. We are going to call them to order. We want to call them to act, to stop using our cars due to their own personal benefit, but to help students, to help community, and safeguard us.
But we also understand that university has some buses that could have been used to transport the students. What do you have to say about that?
After next week, after I'm submitting a memorandum of demand, we are going to the management. We are going to demand a transportation that is mainly based off campus. Because of this, one of the things I'm going to say is that us. But transport alone is not safe. We need police again to extend that safeguarding.
Yeah. So this is about the police of South Africa using the police vehicles to the benefit of our young people. Is that so?
Yeah, indeed.
Yeah.
This is very big for mass of our people. And all general members of South Africa in general. So we are happy to say that at least young people in particular have gathered to say no is no. It's not only about the students, but the poor mass of our people who are meted with violence on a daily basis. We are saying no to that.
So that's really fantastic. You know, I see the crowd, the students, many of them from Mafikeng campus, Northwest University, taking this initiative so that the students are protected. Because remember, the students are coming from different provinces, and that is Limpopo, Gauteng, everywhere.
All over South Africa.
So there are some cases. What are these cases that you guys have been exposed to? The cases?
No, let me make an example. Last year, towards the end of November, we lost one of our own. We went to Palabo to bury that student. Last year, there was a car moving around, taking laptops and everything. On the past week Thursday, one of our students was shot, and she's fighting for her life in the hospital below. So these are the things that we are being exposed to. Our laptops are being taken. Our lives are being threatened here. So we are fighting against that. We are saying police must do something. Police must do something.
Okay. Okay, right now, as you can see behind me, there's such a huge crowd, you know, going all the way to the police station where the memorandum is going to be handed. Is that so?
Yeah, absolutely. We are going to hand over the memorandum to the station commander, and then after we are going to address him to tell him that we need more residents in the campus. We must equally intensify that force, because they are not only police officers. You know that some of them, they are our parents, they are our brothers, they are our sisters. Some of them equally, they enroll in that institution. Therefore, working together, we can ensure that we put pressure on the government to build more residences at the campus and intensify safety and security of our people.
So the whole thing that's going on here is because the university as a whole is facing a problem of accommodation. And as you can see, people are jumping there. Let's just have a serious look. People just behind us here, and they are forming the barricade using their hands. You know, as you can see, the barricade over there. issues right now. It's rising and rising and rising. The students are forming this thing. They're going to go together. They're going to go in. And if you can look just in front of me, there is a... As you can see, there's a police vehicle over there. There's another police vehicle there. This is the police station. This is South African police station. This is where the students are actually marching to. Then we see, so far, it's a peaceful march. It's a peaceful march. Because this is a peaceful march. And it's because some of the students have ended up in the hospital. They're in the hospital as we speak right now. So this is solidarity to try to solve this problem that the students have been facing right now. And it's just almost like the whole school, the whole Mafikeng campus. And this is, we must say that it's fantastic. And, you know, students being together, yeah, as you can see, you know, from that side. How are you? Yes. This is one of the students here. Can you just tell us? Yes, EFF, yeah? Chairperson of?
EFF Student Command, yes.
Yes. Can you, from your side of your party, of EFF, Julius Malema's party, what are you doing? Because I see you guys have united with the SASCO, ANC, Youth League, and everybody. I'm sure the DA members are young. And I know it's a crucial time. Next year is the elections. For the students and representatives, also in August is the elections. Is this march going to benefit you guys?
This march is not about elections or anything. This march is about students.
Yeah.
Our unity is for students. We cannot leave our students to die and our students to get marked while we are doing anything. Now it's time for action. And this is why we are here united as students, not as political parties. We are here as students, not as political parties. And this has nothing to do with elections.
Okay. So this is just united against the violence against the students that is taking place right now. I understand that some students that are in the hospital, and last year you had some cases. What do you have to say about that?
Yes, it's important. We are saying law enforcement agencies of South Africa, they must be improved. We are guided by the words of Thabombe when he said, human despondency have never defeated adversity. So that we are united by the students of the Third University. We want to send a very clear message to the police, that police, they must know that we are here to tell them that they must do their work. They can't continue to earn big salaries when they've got nothing. Our students are gunpointed, our students are shot, our students are killed on a daily basis because of the crime that is taking place between Mutaweng and Dibab.
Yes.
We can't continue to be subjected to that.
We are tired.
Now it's time for action. We are going to act against this. If the police cannot do anything, we are going to act as students. We are going to move these people as students. We are going to come for community partners as students.
This march seems united. It's united of all the political organs that you guys are united to make sure that, you know, this violence against the students must come to an end. So what do you have to say about that? The unity that is
really
crucial time. It's a crucial time.
Really, my cutie, Rivana Rekopani. Katanong le bosenyi jo bo diragalang gantsi mo matlong a re a hirileng re le baithuti. Ka ga jalo re bone go le botlhokwa gore re kopane re le baithuti re tle kgatlhanong le se se diragalang mo re rentileng teng.
Okay, that was Tswana language. You guys, you might get it. That is wonderful. I think what he was trying to say is the students are united. I'm sure
the students are united.
The students are united
behind this.
You know, to make sure. And this is wonderful time that even the police are taking photos. As you can see, the videos as well. This is a fantastic time that the technology has taken us to another level, whereby even the police of South Africa have cameras, you know, to record and to make sure that the intelligence, you know, everything else that is happening, the intelligence is good. And this is wonderful. As you can see, he's taking a film, is filming me, which is wonderful. I love this. And this is good because the students have united to try to make sure that, you know, they march against the violence against the students here. And this is a fantastic time that we have never seen. something like this. Police are carrying cameras. It's not like UK or America. They've got the cameras on their forehead and all that. But this is fantastic. And, you know, yes. And, you know, this is a gentleman that's been marching, one of them. If you see, it's, you know, this is a good cause. What do you have to say, sir?
What do I have to say? Mine is simple. We are tired of Wanakas taking advantage of us. This thing of us being afraid of walking on the streets of Mabat, it is wrong. This thing does not only happen to the people who live in Dibat and Makam, but those of us who live in the units too. We are facing, we are faced with a giant of Wanakas. They are coming to us every night, breaking into our homes, taking our things by force. If you refuse, you are going to be faced with a wrath of guns. Because we are not armed today, no, we are just mere students who are here for our education. Now, they are taking advantage of that. That we are not armed. But if the police are not willing to assist us and they are not willing to bring those, to avail the materials that they avail today, the resources they avail today, like those police vans and hippos, we are going to take law into our hands.
Yeah.
We are going to deal with this Wanakas in a robust manner. We will bring them to them. Yeah. Since when they are failing to give us what we demand.
And this, does this have anything to do with the lack of jobs in Mafikeng or in Northwest Province in South Africa as a whole?
We cannot blame the lack of jobs.
Yeah, yeah.
Because the government in charge here and the majority of people here, they are members of ANC. And the ANC must see to it that these people are employed. Now, if it's about employment, that is an excuse. You can't live in an area where there is a university, where there is resources, like there is legislature here. There are people who can come and become cleaners here. Look at these bushes here. There are people that government can hire to clean this.
Yeah.
This is where we are marked. This is where these people are hiding. Now, if you blame it on job creation, that is nonsense. For how long are we going to beat by the bush and say job creation?
The lady seems to agree with you because we are understand the president, Ramaphosa of South Africa, said that it's going to create 1 million jobs. So is this, you think it's going to solve the problem?
We are
right
waiting.
Now.
Ramaphosa does not have a strategic plan. He was just saying to please the country. And you know, we're not going to listen to Ramaphosa because he's the president of the 244 people that he elected in the elective conference, not us.
Yeah.
We're not going to be told by a man who has been elected by a parliament that is not organized. We're not going to be there.
Yeah.
That is wrong.
Yes, so you guys have heard, you know, these are young people that think differently from old people. So 1 million jobs is impossible, as we can see. The crime rate is going high. The students are suffering. We have got some young ladies here that were, you know, agreeing with everything. And you're one of them. One of the people that are being banned. Now she's running away straight away from the cameras. We're laughing here, but we might end up in the hospital next thing. It's really, what do you have to say?
Yes.
One of the leaders here, EFF, Julius Malema, tell us more.
Can you please go there? Because
All right. Yes. We have a sensitive issue here. They're pushing us away. So we're going to have to be standing very far from everything else. But we're going to go back there with our camera to try to listen and pay attention to what they're saying. Because this is the time that memorandum is being handed over today. We don't know whether it's a police. Can you tell us about the memorandum and whatever you try to hand over to the police?
Well, first and foremost, one cannot begin to articulate this issue without starting with the primary issues of parliament, where the bill that expropriation of land without compensation must be legalized, must happen, must take place this year right now. That is going to then address the issues of students from residents and so forth. For instance, now parliament said and all agreed from opposition to the ruling party that the land expropriation without compensation must happen. But what does that mean to a student who reside there in Dibate? What does it mean to students who stay in there at Musabing? What does it mean to students who's at that hotel? What we are doing as student leaders is that we are relating the very same politics from mainstream politics to students' politics. We are saying students must have accommodation. But as a point of departure, we cannot undermine the issues of health and security. So we are saying to students, to say, let us mobilize ourselves. Let's rally behind the clarion call of safety and security in our universities. We have an incident where a student was shot when he saw on the head, which is the issue of cyber security. So ours is very much simple to say the issue of land invested to give us more land. And equally, South African police services, in as much as we do not want to misplace the role of the police in the society, we are saying police must intervene subsequent to incidents that are happening. But as a point of departure, this is a social illness. It doesn't commence with the subs, because there are subs, they as they intervene after something happened. But what triggered the incident of a crime in the society? There are many issues, issues of unemployment, issues of accommodation, of campus, and all those things. So this is a secondary, but the primary issue is to address social illness.
And handing over the memorandum to the police, will it be able, you know, will it help? Because as far as you just mentioned already, the functions of the police is to react or proact, isn't it?
Absolutely.
When the crime has happened. Now, in this case, we're handing over the memorandum to the police to indicate that we're tired of, you know, the police are not working properly. But are you considering that the police are there to proact and react when the crime has happened? Does it, you know, go together with the handing over of the memorandum to the police? And what are they going to do? Because this is a national police. It's not provincial, it's not local government, whatever. It's national police. Don't you think it was going to be better handing over this to the new police commissioner? Is it police commissioner, I think? Or the minister of police?
Well, absolutely. I can't agree more with your question. You're absolutely correct. However, I'm saying police must then intervene subsequent to the incidences that are happening in the society. For instance, now a student was shot, but by far we're not certain whether those perpetrators were identified. The police must immediate effect, intervene, do the investigations, give us the case number, and make follow-ups with regard to such cases. But equally, the police must be the one conscientizing the very same safety unit in the university. Say, safety unit, what are you doing with these matters? Because students are residing off campus in numbers. For instance, now in campus, we have a plethora of issues. We have postgraduate students who are residing on campus, while we have first-year students who are residing off campus. So basically, what we are saying is that we have two children. The other one is the youngest, the other one is the eldest. You are saying the eldest must stay at home, the youngest must stay outside home. So those are issues that can be addressed through various channels. For instance, by conscientizing the police comrades, intervene, in as much as you understand that you can address this issue, because this issue are psychological, you know, they come from a various perspective in the society.
How are you able to assist to this? We understand that the university has some buses, right? But those buses are not used to bus, you know, the students that are going back to Dibati, you know, very late. One. Two, you said social ills. Some students that are staying in Dibati, obviously, their parents are earning small money, and because that's why they can afford to pay for 500, 300 per month rentals. Then they cannot afford to have. What about addressing this with the university in terms of the buses provision, in terms of the building more accommodation for the students so that no students leaves the campus and goes somewhere? Is that not possible? Is that not feasible?
But your question is careless of the truth, because if you check, you can't say students are parents afford. This is a real university. It's not like you are not addressing VET or UP. Majority, a plethora of students who are studying here, they are from poor families. If you look here, you see that all of them, they are non-white students. All of them are black. If I to use a black consciousness a language or jargon, these students are very poor. They are poor of the poorest. By virtue of them being here demonstrating what is happening, it's because primarily, or as a point of departure, they are poor. So to say they are affording to stay at the party, those places are not even conducive. If they were affording, they were going to pay for residence on time. The issue of residence is not sometimes, it's a matter of the highest bidder who can pay first. Therefore, you pay first and then you allocate your space. So for you to say students can afford to stay at the party, you're careless of the truth, and I can't agree with you with that
you'll forgive me. Yeah, yes, you'll forgive me. Actually, that is, you know, correct.
And
it is correct, yes. Yeah, that is correct. Now, is it not possible to form, you know, sort of partnership with the police so that you work together? You mentioned about, you know, case numbers and things like that. Is it not feasible to form partnership with the police so that these matters can be addressed, you know, when...
Let's put it on record. It's not the first time we come here. We came before SPD leadership to make follow-up with regard to this case, and police were reluctant, and they successfully failed to provide such information. So hence, he brought more numbers to say, if we have more home police, perhaps this comrades of police, they will wake up and realize that this is a serious matter that they need to address. So we're saying, comrades, intervene here. And the issue of saying, like, the latter question to say, no, shouldn't we address this issue to the new police commissioner and all those things? I mean, you start with the branch office of the police. That's a basic unit of the national police. So it will be extremely premature of us to then jump, you know, levels to go to the highest office. It's a bottom up approach.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, you don't start from up and you go down. I mean, you'll be fatigued, will deal with you in due course.
That's wonderful. But now I see there's a name, your operation, hashtag Operation Wanya Wanya.
Wanya Wanya Tuti.
So what does it mean? And you guys are carrying this. This is fantastic. You have got that one day that says stop killing us. You know? What does this say?
Yeah. Wanya Wanya.
How did you come about? And what does it mean, Wanya Wanya?
this operation was formed by the institute there. That operation Wanyatsotsi, it means that operation, you're becoming beaten, like you are dying to see. Like your strength is going down today.
It's weakening, yeah.
Yeah, it's weakening because like we've had enough. Yes, we as the students of NWU.
NWU.
Yeah, because like we're losing a lot of students there at the university.
All right.
So this is the operation which was formed.
Yeah.
A few weeks ago.
Okay. Are we after this march? Are we gonna have another march?
It depends on the response of the.
The police?
SAPS, yes.
SPCL.
If the SAPS responds to us with a better response,
okay.
Then this, I think this match won't go on. I don't think it will go on because if you get the better response, the good response from them.
Thank you very much. I do appreciate it.
Thank you.
So now we're going to take you guys there, you know, and then find out what they're talking about. You can cut for now, then we're going to take another video when we're there. All right. Thank you. Thank you.